Mic check 1, 2. Hey, there we go. No singing allowed. Not for me. Sounds good? Thanks. We're good.
Test, 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 test. That sounds good. All right. We're on camera. There's a frightening thought. Welcome to Jazz Evensong here at Brentwood Presbyterian Church in Burnaby, BC. Those of you that are with us in person, great to have you in that mode, as we say these days. For those of you joining us on the live stream, great to have you participating in that mode as well. And then for then, we're going to get John out of the way out of the way of the camera. And for those of you watching this on our YouTube channel, asynchronously after we post it, we're delighted to have you participating in that way. My name is Brian Fraser. I have had the privilege of being the minister in this wonderful little congregation. Brentwood does sit on the traditional and ancestral lands, unceded lands, of the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh nations. And so we acknowledge that we are guests of them. In 1994, the denomination that this church is part of, the Presbyterian Church in Canada, confessed to God and to our Indigenous kin. And there's a copy of the confession on the table at the back if you want to take it and read through it. But the phrase in that confession that continues to haunt me is our confession that we misrepresented Jesus in our relations with our Indigenous kin. And I think that is so true. And so part of that confession is a commitment to continue to work in dialogue with our Indigenous kin, with each other, and obviously with God, to try and figure out better ways of living together and living out the gospel of forgiveness and reconciliation. Delighted to have with us this evening Johannes Grams on guitar, Cameron Hood on the new fancy bass, and Jerry Cooke on sax. Great to have you in the house. Let's open with a prayer. O Spirit of our Creator's Christ, Jesus of Nazareth, you draw us here with welcoming love. You draw us here from neighborhoods of struggle and strife bearing stress injuries of all kinds. And in the safety of this sanctuary, you heal us into greater wholeness. So in this time, in this place, at this point in our lives, through the medium of the music this evening, the reflections and the prayers, inspire and equip us to be faithful, wise, and effective ambassadors of your forgiving and reconciling love. And I'm going to let Jerry introduce the music and turn it over to you, gentlemen.
Thanks, Brian. We're going to do start with a couple of tunes. We're going to do them back to back. Happens to be two songs written by trumpet players. But this was just coincidence. One of my favorite jazz composers ever, Clifford Brown. Sandu, we're going to start with, and then to Siora, written by Lee Morgan. Here we go.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was a couple of nice tunes, Sandu and Ciora. We're going to do two more kind of back-to-back. How's that, Brian? A couple more. Okay, we're going to do lots of time. Good. We're going to do Weaver of Dreams and then go into Green Dolphin Street. A couple old jazz standards I'm sure you'll recognize. And we'll see how that goes. Sounds good, Cam. How's you feeling?
Thank you.
Well, this nice new bass here, half of it missing. Doing good. Okay, thank you. We're going to do a couple more. Here we go. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. What a delight. Thank you. 4 months, eh, Cam? Not bad, kid. You got promise. Oh, you young whippersnapper, you. Oh, Johannes Groms on guitar. Cam Hood on bass. Jerry Cooke on sax. So for those of you new to Jazz Evensong here at Brentwood, welcome. We're delighted to have you with us this evening. What I normally do in my little gig on these evenings is find a quote about, well, tonight's quote is more about music than about specifically about jazz, and then just riff for a few minutes on it. I'm particularly intrigued by what the wit, wisdom, and workings of jazz can teach us about how we live together. And because I'm a minister in a Christian congregation, Presbyterian congregation, the context that I focus on a lot is the context of how does the church be more faithful in representing God's forgiving and reconciling love in the world, the way we see it modeled in Jesus, the Creator's Christ. But tonight's words of reflection come from a guy by the name of Karl Polnack. And this was his 2004 commencement address to the Boston Conservatory of Music. Not known as a great jazz school, but a great music school. And I think there is... there's something in this quote worth considering around the way in which music addresses, satisfies, fulfills our most basic human needs. We had an interesting conversation about that at our Bible study a couple of weeks ago. Wednesday afternoon, it's on Zoom. You're more than welcome to join us anytime. The link is always on the homepage of our website, BrentwoodPCC.com. But Thomas Keating is one of the thought leaders in a movement called contemplative prayer within the Christian tradition. And Keating says humans have three basic needs. The need for security, the need for appreciation, and the need for power. For agency, for the sense of the ability to do something significant. And so I translate that into security, satisfaction, and significance. Right? So how do you generate a sense that you are sufficiently safe to do something, to take the initiative, to be creative? How are you satisfied that's been good, that's been significant, and how do you compose, self-compose your significance in the world? So I think this relates to those things. Music, says Polnack, is a basic need of human survival. Music is one of the ways we make sense of our lives, one of the ways in which we express feelings when we have no words, a way for us to understand things with our hearts when we can't understand them with our minds. He says, I'm not an entertainer. I'm a lot closer to a paramedic, to a firefighter, to a rescue worker, right? I mean, here he is, 2004, he's talking to this entire auditorium filled with musicians who've probably never thought of themselves in that way before. I'm a lot closer to a paramedic, a firefighter, a rescue worker. Boy, do we know how important those people are in our context today. You're here, he tells these musicians, to become a sort of therapist for the human soul, a spiritual version of a chiropractor, a physical therapist, a masseuse, as my wife Jill was for 25 years in her business at Runaway Bay. Somebody who works with our insides to see if they can get things to line up, to see if we can come into harmony with ourselves and be healthy and happy and well. And in that wellness, this is my ad, he finished there, in that wellness, become of significance to the well-being of creation. So it's not just about the individual musicians. It's not just about these three musicians up here who are having these wonderful conversations with each other. We're all involved in those conversations. Right? We don't make a lot of noise. You bounce back and forth on these wonderful chairs that you can dance in. You make grunts and you applaud every now and then. Somebody in the audience says, yeah, happens to be the minister, but, you know, how I feel, what can I say? And I'm not alone in expressing those things. But that sense in which all of us, as we participate in the vibe of this music, are both fed to flourish, nourished to flourish, and then, as we will say in the benediction, and then we take that vibe into literally every contact we have in the coming weeks, in the coming days. And so I just want to say thanks to these three therapists for a wonderful evening. And we'll get back to the music.
Thanks, Brian. Going to hand this over to Cam. Cam's going to do a little, yeah.
Going to hand it over to Cam. Okay.
Be warned.
Hi there. There's a wonderful young bassist in Vancouver that I just want to give a shout out to, named Colin. Oh, my goodness. Wow. Hi there. No, that's not him. No, sorry. It's one of my former bass students. Wow, amazing. Thank you for coming. Incredible. Now I've completely lost my train of thought. What's Colin's last name?
Sankey.
Yes. There's a wonderful young bassist named Colin Sankey who just absolutely blew me away when I first heard him. He's up there challenging the best bassists in the world. They're having all these online sort of duels on who can outdo each other. But also the amazing thing about Colin is he does 3 and 4 hour solo bass gigs, just him and a looper pedal, and does absolutely incredible stuff. And I mean, this guy is world class to the point where he won an invitation to the Phil Jones International solo bass competition and won. Beat all the Americans, all the big money people who'd been to Berkeley and all of that stuff, a little kid from Chilliwack here. So I've been coaching him along a little bit. I got him an endorsement deal with Tobias Basses, and he's having a beautiful custom-made Colin Sankey model coming out soon. Anyway, at the age of 64, once again, I've taken up looping. So this is my inaugural run at this tonight. So I've been a little bit nervous. I was a little bit cranky to the boys here earlier. So please forgive me. But Colin, you're an inspiration, man. This is dedicated to my sweetie. It's called Sugar.
Yeah, Cameron Hood. Nice work. It's worth bringing all that stuff. Nice work. Yeah, Cam. Yeah, of course. We're going to do a jazz waltz by Frank Foster called Simone.
Thank you.
Yeah, nice. We're almost out of time, but we could do a couple of more. We're going to make them a little shorter, guys. We're going to do famous old Black Orpheus from, what's it called, Mañana de Carnival? No, that's a different one. What's it from? Black Orpheus is the movie, and it's the name of the song. It's a bossa. We're going to do that and then go into a last tune called Afternoon in Paris. There's a couple. Thank you very much for all coming out. Thank you very much to Brian and the church here. And to Court and Jim doing our sound and YouTube. Thank you very much. Thank you all for coming. Black Orpheus.
Thank you.
Thanks again. We're going to do one short little John Lewis number called Afternoon in Paris. Thanks again to Brian and Cam Hood, bass. Jonas Grammas on guitar. Myself, Jerry Cooke. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Oh, wonderful. Once again, deep gratitude. Johannes Groms, Cam Hood, Jerry Cooke. Our pleasure. Thanks so much for being with us. And thank you to all of you who joined in this evening of wonderful musicking. Those of you who have joined us online live, we're delighted to have you here as well. And for those of you watching this asynchronously after it's posted to our YouTube channel, thank you for participating as well. There are other ways, other than clapping, of showing your appreciation for the musicians tonight. There is a brown thanks bucket, fine old New Orleans tradition, at the back. If you didn't catch it on the way in, please catch it on the way out. Or there's a QR code that'll take you to our Canada Helps page. And online, for e-transfer, there's an email, pamwong76@yahoo.ca, which is another way of giving us money to give to the musicians. So thank you very, very much for your generosity there. Beyond the thanks bucket, there is a weird-looking pottery foot done by the same guy, Bob Kingsmill, who's done the mural at the front of the church. Originally, we were appealing for money to go buy socks. And then take the socks down to First United Church in the downtown east side, and they distributed the socks to their neighbors. The reason we did that was that we thought that socks were the least donated item of clothing for people in the downtown east side and similar places. We discovered in conversation with First United that there is a lesser donated item of clothing, and that is underwear. So we're now collecting money to buy underwear. So that's where your money will go in the foot. Over a 9-year period, we've taken down over 30,000 pairs of socks. They're a little less expensive than underwear. So I think we're up to 200 pairs of underwear so far. So anyhow, that's another way of helping out through Brentwood. Next week we have the same configuration of instruments with Steve Caldestat on sax and Conrad Good on bass and Dave Sekula on guitar. So we're looking forward to that. 8 o'clock on Wednesday night. We do this every Wednesday night. You're more than welcome to join us anytime you want. There is a blank sheet at the back, and I think there's a pen somewhere close by. If you want to get on our email list to find out what's going on, just put your name and your email, and we'll make sure that happens. One of the other churches that we're working closely with is Trinity Grace United Church. So it's on 16th, about a block away from Fraser and Kingsway. They're beginning to do monthly jazz services, jazz events. And this fall, they're going to be doing 4 sacred jazz suites, 3 of which have been commissioned by Brentwood. And so we begin on the 22nd of September with they're at 7 o'clock, 7:30. They're at 7:30 with Dean Thiessen's Stranger Friends doing their Good Samaritan Suite. That's on the 22nd of September. Then Dan Reynolds, who's our own pianist here, Dan's done a suite based on the Prodigal Son, and another suite based on the Sower. So that's October 20th. November 17th, and then Quintessential Jazz, one of the jazz groups that hangs around here and rehearses here on a regular basis. They're going to do a Christmas suite on December the 15th. So those are all by donation. This Sunday night, 7 o'clock, Caden Gordon Quintet are doing a benefit, which is a tribute to Chet Baker. Caden plays trumpet. Comes out of Chilliwack as well. That seems to be quite a fruitful scene for jazz musicians. Yeah. Anyhow, they're doing a tribute to Chet Baker, and the proceeds, all it's by donation. All of the donations will go to the Canadian Mental Health Association. And then on September the 22nd, Bruno Hubert, so Bruno's an amazing pianist, but also takes care of our piano almost on a weekly basis. He's getting ready to go back into the studio to record again with Joe Poole and Winston Minkler. And so we're doing a benefit with that trio for that recording on September the 22nd at 8 p.m. Here at Brentwood. So that's what's coming up in the next little while. Lots of jazz here, and we so appreciate the support of musicians like these and folks like you. It's a delight to be able to enjoy this amazing music and the healing that comes from it. As a result of being together this evening, we now know more deeply that our Creator's hospitality embraces us. We now know more deeply that our Christ's hope inspires us. And we now know more deeply that our Spirit's healing energizes us. So let's go forth, inspired by the provocative peace of Christ, our Creator's, provocative peace of Jesus, our Creator's Christ, and take this vibe into all of our networks. Amen. Oh, and I should have said, don't cut us off yet, Jim. Thanks to Court. Court's back with us after a summer of romping around Montreal, and she came back, right? Very intelligent young person. And Jim Smith, who's our live streamer, minister, and association, thanks both of you. Great to have the team back together. God bless. Safe home.